Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about how we can invoke HTTP request in React. In this video, I'm going to explain about form handling in React. Let's start. Forms are used to collect information from end users. When the user fills out a form and clicks the submit button, the form data will be sent for processing. Form handling is about how you handle the data when it changes value or gets submitted. Usually, we can divide the form handling into a three-step process: form creation, form validation, and form submission. And in frameworks like Angular, we have a separate module for handling forms. But in React, either we need to go for some third-party NPM packages, or we can write our own logic. In this video, I'm going to explain you how we can do form handling in React using our own code. For that, I have created a React application. I'm going to use Bootstrap, because using Bootstrap, we can easily style our form fields. To use Bootstrap, I need to first install Bootstrap. I can install Bootstrap using this command. Now, Bootstrap is installed inside node modules, and so we can use this bootstrap.css. Let me import the bootstrap.css in index.js. In app.js, I'm just having a h2 tag and then a div which is having a class form container. And I have applied some CSS. Let me start the server. Now we can see this. Okay, like I told before, our first step is going to be form creation. So let me introduce a form element. Inside that, I'm going to create our first form field. In Bootstrap, we have a class called form group, which can be used to group the form fields like label and input box. So first let me create a div with class name as form group. And then inside that, let me create a label. Please note that in JSX, we have to use HTML for instead of for. And then let me create an input type text with an ID. To this, I can add the Bootstrap class name form control. Okay, our first field is ready. Let me quickly create another field for email. Another number field for age. A drop-down for department. And a checkbox. For checkbox alone, we need to have a little bit different structure. I have added this to style it correctly. Finally, a submit button of type submit. I have a question here. Can you think why I am saying that we need to create a button of type submit? Why not a button of type button? A button is just that, a button, to which we can add additional functionality using JavaScript. In the meantime, a submit input type has the default functionality of submitting the form. Let me create another button. Let it be of type button. I'm going to use this button to clear my form fields. So here also, instead of button, I can use the type as reset. But I wanted to show you how we can reset our form manually. And so let me keep this type as button. Okay, now if I click this button, nothing happens because there is no event added. Let me create a function. And let me add that using an onClick handler. Now also we are not seeing any difference. But if I have a console log inside this function, we can see that on clicking this button. Okay, let me click this button. Now we can see a question mark is added in the URL. That means something has happened. Let me create a function. And let me bind that to this form using an onSubmit handler. Now if I have a console log and click this button, we can only see the console log message only for a fraction of a second. Because every time when we click the submit button, the page refreshes. That is the default behavior. But we can use the prevent default method from the event to change the default behavior. Like this. Now if I click, we can see the page is not getting refreshed. Hope you understood. Okay, now we have created our form. Next step is to validate the input. For that, first we need to find a way to get the values from the form fields. In React, we have already seen either we can use useState approach or useRef approach. For this demo, we are not going to change anything in the UI based on the form fields. We are just going to collect the values and send for processing. To be more specific, we are just going to log those values in the console. That's it. So we don't want to go for useState approach. And so let me create useRef for each field. And then let me bind that to the respective form fields. Okay, now we can access these fields and their values. So let's do form validation. For that, I'm going to create a separate function. Inside this function, let me get the values of each field and let me store in some variables. Please note that for all input fields and dropdown, I have used respective ref.current.value. But for checkbox, I have used ref.current.checked. This will give us true or false. Now we need to write some logic to validate the values based on our business requirement. Let me define our requirement. Let me keep it simple. Full name, email, and department fields should be required. That means they cannot be left blank. And email should be in a standard email format. Finally, user has to check this checkbox to submit the form. And we are not going to test all the negative scenarios like entering number in name field, etc. That will deviate us from learning the concept. Okay, and we need to show the error messages to the end user. For that, we need to maintain few states. Let me create those. Initially, I am assigning them as empty string. And when there is an error, I'm going to assign the respective error message. For example, our first requirement is going to be full name is required. So let me check whether full name dot trim is equal to empty string. If it is so, let me set the error message as full name is required. And then let me come to this form group. And here, let me add a span with class as error. And let me show the message. Even for this error class, I have already added CSS. Okay. So now we can call this function inside our handle submit function so that we can test this validate form function. Okay, I'm going to submit the form without any value. And so we can see the error message. Similarly, let me do this for the email field. Okay, let's test. I'm going to submit the form without entering any values. Now it is throwing error, full name is required. Now let me enter some value for full name and then submit. Now the email is required error is showing, but the full name error is not cleared. So what we can do? Inside this block, we can reset the full name error. Now we can see it is working. So we have to follow this approach for other fields as well. Okay, our next requirement is to validate whether the email is in valid format. For that, let me create a new function called validateEmail, which accepts email as parameter and it tests that against this rejects pattern. This is the pattern for validating an email format. If the test is success, let me return true, or otherwise let me return false. Now I can call this function and let me pass the email. If this is going to fail, let me set the email is not valid error message. Here also, let me reset the full name error message. Now let me test this. Okay, it is working. Let's move to the next requirement, which is department should not be blank. This is similar to the full name requirement. Let me copy this and modify according to our need. Finally, we need to validate whether the user has checked this checkbox or not. For that, I can simply check like this. If not agreed, I'm clearing the department error and setting the agreed error as please agree with terms and conditions. Okay, let me test it. After the checkbox is also checked, we need to clear the agreed error message. And so let me introduce an else block and let me clear the agreed error. Okay, let me test it once. It is working. Now we need to proceed with form submission if the form validation is success. For that, first let me declare a variable inside validate form function and let me initialize that as false. And inside else block, let me change that to true. Finally, let me return that variable. So if the form validation is success, this method will return true, otherwise false. So in handle submit function, let me get that in a variable and let me check that variable. And only when it is true, I'm going to call another function called submit form. Let me also create the submit form function. Ideally, this is the function in which we can build our payload and invoke the API. But for now, let me console log the values of the form fields. Okay, let me test it once. So when the form is not valid, form is not getting submitted. And when the form is valid, we can see the console logs. That means the form is getting submitted. Okay, after the form is submitted, we need to clear the form fields. So after this, let's call reset form function. And in reset form function, we can reset the form field values like this. Also, we need to reset the error messages. Let's test it once. Okay, it is working. It would be good if you highlight the field which is having error and focus that field as well. To highlight the field which is having error, we just need to dynamically add this class, which we can add it using the template string, like this. I have already added CSS for this. And so we can see the field having error is highlighted. Both the color of the label and the border are changed to red. And to focus the field, we can use the respective ref.current.focus. Let me test it. It is working as expected. Hope you understood how we can handle forms. Let me give you a task. You can develop the same form, but you can disable the submit button. You have to enable only when the form is valid. Also, display all the error message when user types or selects in the form field. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can get it from this repo. The link is also available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.